YouTubers, it's Caitlin from Cosmetic Confessions. Today I'm going to be talking to you about some of my favorite hair products and my hair product recommendations and a little bit about my hair routine. I've had a lot of people ask me questions about my hair, ask me to do a hair tutorial video, things like that, and I will definitely do a hair tutorial just of how I do my regular, like, everyday straight hair. And also, I've curled my hair in a couple of videos, and people have asked for tutorials with that, too. So, I will do that in the future, I promise. But, I'm just gonna talk to you about some of my favorite hair products, because I don't talk about hair products very often at all. And that is mostly because I'm a little bit clueless when it comes to hair. I'm not that great at doing hair. My hair is just long and straight and brown and... yeah, I'm not that great at doing really nice hairdos or anything like that, but I have found some products that I really like, and this will be especially helpful to you if you have hair like mine. My hair, I'll just tell you a little bit about my hair type. Basically, my hair is very thin, and I've never colored it before, so it's extremely healthy, but because it's so healthy, it has no body at all. Like, what you need to make your hair have volume is literally, you need to, like, fry it up a little bit. And even though I straighten my hair all the time, it doesn't do anything. Like, I never get split ends or anything like that. So I like that aspect of my hair. It's very, very soft and silky, but because it's so soft and so silky, if I try to backcomb it or anything like that, it'll just fall flat 2 seconds later. Even like my hairdresser can't get it to really stay up. And also if I put in an updo, it'll often like slip out and I have to make sure I put a lot of hairspray. But and another thing about having fine hair like mine is that it gets dirty looking really quickly. So if I don't wash my hair for a day, you can usually like it'll look greasy the next day. Which is really annoying, but I have found some ways to deal with that. So I'm just gonna get started and talk about the products. First thing, obviously, to talk about is shampoo and conditioner. And I've been using these ones for a couple weeks, and this is a Live Clean Exotic Nectar Argan Oil Restorative Shampoo and Restorative Conditioning Mask. And they just look like this. And I really like these. They are 100% natural, and they are 98% plant-derived. So, they're definitely sodium lauryl and sodium laureth sulfate free, and that's really important to me because for me, I started using natural shampoos maybe back in the summer last year, and it really made a difference because I used to get like a really itchy dry scalp and I would get like rashes on my scalp, and since I switched over to using 100% natural shampoos, that has completely cleared up and my scalp is really healthy, and I just like that they don't leave any sort of buildup in your hair. This shampoo and conditioner also are quite moisturizing without making your hair look greasy or weighed down, so really like these. I think you can only get these in Canada though, and I bought these at Walmart for $5 each, so they're really inexpensive. If you live in the States and you can't get a hold of the Live Clean products and you don't want to order them online, another brand that I'd recommend for 100% natural or almost 100% natural shampoos is the Alba Botanica. I believe it's the Gardenia shampoo and conditioner, but they weren't as moisturizing, so if you have dry hair, you might want to consider using something different. Next would be, after I wash my hair, I usually put some sort of conditioning product in my ends, like after I'm out of the shower, just in my ends, like literally the very end part here, just so that it doesn't get frizzy looking if I'm after I blow dry it or anything like that. And there's two products that I use, and I use them depending on how healthy my hair is, I guess. So if my hair is, if it's been recently cut and it's not dry at all, I'll just use this Sunsilk Hydra TLC 24/7 cream. This is really inexpensive. This is not a natural product, but it is like $2, and it's just a cream, like it's just a white cream like that, and you just like rub it your hands together and then apply it to the ends of your hair, and I do this when it's wet, not when it's dry because that would make it look greasy, but it's just nice and moisturizing and it smells really good, and it doesn't make your hands feel sticky. I just rubbed it in my hands after I poured that in my hands, and Yeah, I really like this. I've been using this since high school. Not necessarily this, the pink colored one, but all the 24/7 creams, they all have kind of a similar texture, just a different scent, and there's all different colors, and I think this is $2 or something like that. If my hair is a little bit less healthy and I'm starting to get some split ends and it's in need of a trim pretty soon, I'll use this BioSilk Silk Therapy kind of, it's like a serum, and it's really works really well. And I've literally had this bottle since high school, and I'm in my fourth year of university now, so I've had this for like 5 years, and I don't think it's gone bad, because you need such a small amount. You literally put the amount smaller than a dime size in your hands. You rub it together. It's really moisturizing. You can also apply this on your skin, and it smells really good. And I really like how this works in my hair, but you have to be careful. Only apply this to your ends. Don't apply it anywhere near your roots, or your hair will look like a grease ball. Another product that I recently started using, which, to be honest with you, it's not a holy grail product or anything like that, but I just like it on some days when I don't apply this all the time, but this is called Bedhead Superstar Blow Dry Lotion for thick, massive hair. And it's just supposed to be like a volumizing serum that I would apply this to my roots. I don't think it makes that much of a difference in my hair, to be honest with you, but it doesn't make my hair look greasy, and it smells so good. And I got this for Christmas, and I've just been using it, and to be honest with you, I don't think I'll repurchase this, but I just really, it smells so good. So, and most of the Bedhead products smell really good. So I do use this once in a while if I'm blow drying my hair and I just want a little bit more volume, or a little bit of volume at all. Another thing that's really important, especially if you have fine hair, is I really am paranoid. I do not want my hair ever looking greasy at all. And the best product that I found, if you want, because I only wash my hair every second day usually, but on that second day I don't want it looking greasy or smelling funky or anything like that. And so I found that dry shampoo is an amazing, amazing product. I just love it. This is Pst Instant Spray Shampoo. I bought this in New York at Walgreens last summer, and it's like almost gone. And so I've never seen this in Canada before. If you live in Canada and you've bought this in Canada before, let me know where, because that would be really greatly appreciated. But I do need to find another brand, a drugstore brand of dry shampoo to replace this if I can't find it in Canada. But if you live in the States, this is the only brand of dry shampoo I've ever tried. And I really liked how it worked, and it didn't give me white looking roots or anything like that. It didn't leave my hair with a weird texture or anything like that, and it smelled pretty good. So this worked really well for me, and it was really inexpensive, probably like $6. So, and that's something I definitely recommend. Another like little tip for if you want to wear your hair like the second day after washing it, is what I do is I don't wash my whole hair, obviously, but I just wash my bangs, because my bangs are the area that really get greasy looking faster. So I'll just put my hair up in a ponytail in the morning, and then I'll just wash, literally shampoo like this little piece, and then I'll just blow dry that. And that is just kind of my way of ensuring that my hair doesn't look greasy, because a telltale sign of greasy hair is if you have greasy bangs like sticking to your forehead and stuff like that. So definitely a tip that I use, and I actually told my hairdresser about that, and she said that was actually such a good idea, because she said she washes her hair every day, but her ends are getting really dry from it. So that's a good suggestion. And the last product that I want to talk about is, this is just Herbal Essences Body Envy Volumizing Hairspray. And to be honest with you, this is not like a holy grail, oh my god, I have to buy this hairspray every single time. I just like this because it smells really good. It doesn't leave my hair feeling crunchy, and it's only $1.50. And some of the brands of hairspray, even at the drugstore, are like $14. And really, they perform the same as this. So I like this a lot. And it also, if I'm using this for an updo, it's like the perfect all-around hairspray, because you can spray it on your hair if your hair is down without it making it crunchy, but you can also spray this in an updo and it'll actually stay put. So I really like this, and it has like a nice citrus smell. It doesn't have that like gross hairspray smell. So I really like that. And those are basically the hair products that I use. I know I listed a lot, but, you know, shampoo and conditioner are obvious ones. And then I just apply a little bit of stuff to my ends after I'm out of the shower. And, you know, hairspray is an obvious one because I have, like, little pieces that break off all the time. So if I don't spray them down, it'll be like, psh. And the only other things I wanted to talk about for my hair video are the styling tools that I use on a daily basis. Pretty much daily basis, I use my Qi straightener. And I know this isn't really, like, the best anymore. I know that a lot of people have talked about the GHD and how that one is a lot better than this one because, I don't know, it heats up in 1 minute and it, like, beeps or something like that. I still think this works really well for me. I can straighten my hair in the morning when it's all crazy, after I've gone to bed with it wet and it's, like, looking crazy. I can straighten my hair with this, my whole hair, in about 10 minutes, and it's, like, poker straight. And it heats up really quickly, and I've had this for 4 years, and it's still going strong. So, definitely, I love my Qi straightener. And they're a lot less expensive nowadays. They're only, like, $150 now, and they used to be, like, $200, so... and another thing, when I blow dry my hair, I don't blow dry my hair very often because usually I take showers at night and then I go to bed and let it dry overnight, and that protects my hair. It's a lot better for your hair. But if I do blow dry my hair, I literally use, like, a no-name. This is, like, a little blow dryer that I've had since high school, and I think it's, well, the sticker's rubbed off, but it's from a brand called V.S. Sassoon, and I don't know, a lot of people have talked about how buying an expensive blow dryer makes such a big difference, but I don't really have frizzy hair or problems with that, so I don't really worry about spending like $200 on a blow dryer. And the only other thing I guess I'll talk about is, just gotta pull it out here, is my really one and only curling iron that actually works, because my hair doesn't hold a curl very well. But I'm going to order some different size of these, and this is the Hot Tools Professional gold plated curling iron. This is really inexpensive. I bought this in New York for like $25. These used to be a lot more expensive, but nowadays they're not that expensive, and it gets super hot. It has a setting that goes up to 10, and it heats up really quickly, and it holds a curl, and this is a 1-inch, I believe. And it actually works really well, and I can make really tight curls with it or looser curls if I just don't hold it as long. So this is like my go-to. This is really all I need, although I would like to buy a curling iron that has a bigger barrel, but, you know, that's not necessary. So yeah, those are my hair product recommendations. I hope you found this somewhat helpful. I hope to be doing some more hair videos in the near future. It's just that I don't have the perfect setup. Like, I would like to figure out a better setup to show you better. And also, I'm not the most savvy hair person, so I just, you know, I'll maybe show you guys how I curl my hair or something like that, or how to curl your hair with a straightener. I'll think of something fun. But I hope you found those hair product recommendations a little bit helpful. And, another video that I'm probably going to be doing sometime soon is, showing you how I henna my hair. And I've hennaed my hair twice, and I used the Lush, henna bar, and it just looks like this, and it literally is the same color as my hair, but it just, like, really richens it up, and it makes your hair really shiny. So I might do a video tutorial on that coming up soon, I hope, if I, you know, make a day to do that. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to my channel if you're interested, and have a really, really great day. Bye, guys.